$12 cleaning bill, but the stain's still there. Now, in a CBS 2 News investigation, find out why your favorite laundry could be taking you to the cleaners. Special assignment on CBS 2 News at 11.
Tonight.
Judd Nelson, David Cassidy, and Curtis Williams Jr. on Howard.
The address is CBS. Welcome home.
Brad, this really isn't a good time.
Hey, now is as good a time as any. Toast time!
Brad, really appreciate you coming out tonight, bringing the house and all, but Bob Hughes just made a great toast, and I think you about said it all, don't you?
No, no way, man. Are you kidding? An occasion like this, people gotta speak up.
Brad, it's not your party.
Yeah, Look, a lot of people think I shouldn't say a word, but they're wrong. You see, I want to make a toast, and that's what I'm going to do. I got every right to. Because I'm not just a bystander here. I got my own special take on things. And when it comes to whether or not this couple here is going to be happy, well, I really know something about that.
Die, David. You deserved it. You don't exist. You are dead. You are dead. Oh, my God. Oh. It's the same one. It's the same one.
Lucinda, what the hell are you doing? Stop pumping Lily for information. You're just upsetting her. Don't you understand anything?
Oh, do I understand? Indeed I do, because I know what you did to David.
Look, I know it's late, but Matthew, let me in, and what? This can't wait.
What is it?
It's David.
What?
I just heard some very shocking news. It just can't
heard
wait.
Some shocking news?
Yeah.
So then, you know what happened to David.
You. You're this baby's father. Not David, you.
I'm the anonymous donor. Assuming that Hal is out of the picture, and that's pretty good assumption. Yes, I am the father of your child.
Yes. Oh, man, when you want to do a slash and burn on someone's life, you're pretty thorough, aren't you?
Because first you torture me, and you tell me that I could be carrying David Stenbeck's baby. You talking. That's the great doctor who tells me not to be stressed out, who tells me not to put this baby's life at risk, and you tell me a lie like that, and then you top it off, you tell me an even worse lie.
I had to
my
say
God, something. You must really hate me.
My feelings for
you. You shut up. You just shut up, because I'm not going to stand here and play this absurd mind game with you. Get out of my way.
I am not lying to you now.
You are. Now,
no.
Get out of my way.
I admit that I lied to you about David Stenbeck, but that was to get Hal off of our backs. It was also to keep you from knowing the truth.
Shut up.
I am not going to shut up. This thing is not going to go away. Now it's time you knew the truth. It's time you accepted the truth.
No,
stopped taking these unnecessary risks. Listen to me. It is more than likely I am the father of your child.
As the world turns.
I'm sorry about the story about David Stenbeck. It was appalling, and I'm very sorry for that. We were trapped. What could we do? Hal had to be told something, and so I did, off the top of my head. I had no idea that James Stenbeck was somehow going to find out about this. And of course, I certainly don't blame you for wanting a paternity test. God, who wouldn't? But of course, now that you know the truth and what all, I don't really think that it's necessary.
Just wait a minute. Wait a damn minute here. This isn't even possible. How, How dumb do you think I am? I was there, remember? Mm-hmm. I know that you went into Dr. Samuel's office and you took that equipment. Yeah, yeah, and then you went into the lab and you took
wait a minute.
A donor sample.
Wait a minute. We got to the lab and I found the freezer padlocked. There was no way I could get
into
it. We're running out of time. There wasn't any time left, if you remember right. You were losing Hal. I was losing Barbara. You were very anxious about this thing, and so was I. And when I found that the padlock was this freezer, I couldn't get into it.
No.
I narrowed it down to one possibility, and that was myself.
Sorry I'm late. I was at my doctor and...
Oh, did you ask her about the things you've been reading about menopause?
I did. She said,
it's important to consider menopause and the consequences of its associated estrogen loss.
You mean like hot flashes?
Hot flashes and night sweats, but other things too, like vaginal dryness. It can interfere with intimacy.
And osteoporosis. I know that menopause increases our risk of fractures.
Dr. Hartman also said,
studies show that menopause contributes to heart disease in women. Additional ongoing studies are investigating the connection between menopause and Alzheimer's disease, colon cancer, blindness, and tooth loss.
I had no idea.
My doctor and I decided to stick with the program we've agreed on for years.
I should speak to my doctor.
When considering menopause, consider the entire body of evidence. Speak to your doctor about what you can do to help protect your health during and after menopause.
Aw, man, just a sandwich? I almost left my soup on the bus.
Nothing turns an ordinary sandwich into a satisfying meal, like the taste of rich, wholesome Campbell soup.
Soup.
No, your mother gave you chicken noodle soup.
Oh.
My mother gave me tomato.
Hey, here we go again.
Campbell's, good for the body, good for the soul. One of these women uses Suave Herbal Care Shampoo. The other pays more for Clairol Herbal Essences. Both have hair that looks naturally beautiful and revitalized. So who uses Suave and who pays a lot more? If you can't tell, why should we? Suave. Don't you look smart? Introducing Suave Antibacterial Hand Soap. Now you can kill germs and moisturize as you wash your hands of high prices. Suave. Don't you look smart?
What are you talking about?
What?
What are you talking about?
Talking about me? I was merely asking a question.
No, no, it sounded to me like you knew what had happened to David.
I don't know. I don't know anything. I just know all the Emily business with David calling her and all of that, but you said you had shocking news. Well, what have you learned?
Well, I'm afraid it has nothing to do with where David actually is.
Oh, James, I'm so sorry.
No, but still, it's amazing. I mean, John Dixon told Hal Munson that he's not the father of Carly's baby, that David's the father.
What? Good God.
Yeah, no, artificial insemination. I mean, apparently David was an anonymous donor at the hospital, and Dixon uses David's sperm to inseminate Carly.
Oh, no, I don't believe that.
No, you wouldn't believe it because you're not a desperate father trying to find his missing son. I believed it. I wanted to believe it. It gave me hope. It gave me...
Yes,
thought that the part of David was living on, but...
It's highly unlikely, James.
Yes, but it seems that Carly and John are in some kind of trouble, and Dixon said all that to Hal just to throw him off track. But where there's smoke, there's bound to be a fire. I'm going to have a paternity test done the minute that child is born.
I think it's highly unlikely.
I know. I know it's highly unlikely, and that's the awful part of it for me. I mean, the thought that David could be leaving behind a child makes me miss him even more. Makes me more determined to find him.
How could you do this to me?
You came, you've requested this procedure.
With an anonymous donor, John! What in God's name made you think that I would ever want it to be you?
You were ovulating, you remember? We didn't have any time. And yet we took all this time rejecting this prospect, that prospect. He was too short, he was too tall, this one wasn't going to be the intellectual genius that Hal was.
So this is my fault now.
So by the time I got down there, and I saw that I could not get into the sperm bank itself, I could not get into the freezer, it was padlocked, I couldn't get in, I was stuck.
Stop it, just stop. You knew.
I knew what?
You knew when you came back from the lab, you knew that you didn't have a sample, you knew that you were just gonna...
Listen to me. If I hadn't, you would have gone home without a child.
Oh, my God. You're the donor.
I am the donor.
Just when exactly were you planning on telling me about this?
Never.
Okay, Brad, you've had a few, and you always get talking when you've had a few, but now's not the time, okay?
Were you with the party police? I'm giving a toast here, right? I got it.
Hey, listen, I don't care if you embarrass yourself. You're not the only Snyder here, though.
I have no intention of embarrassing myself, okay? I'm gonna say something nice in public about the finest woman that I've ever known. Camila is so beautiful. She's so... That doesn't mean a thing. It's who she is that's so remarkable. You know, she's warm and gentle. And she's giving. And she's so damn strong. I mean, you gotta admire this woman's courage from the first night I met her. I mean, her ability to love.
Brad, that's enough.
No, look, I am not finished, all right? Damn, I deserve to be a part of this woman's life. Nobody understands this. And I didn't understand this. Until just recently.
Showtime.
Tissue on your list, you want a tissue that's comfortable. So just remember three words of comfort. Soft. Kleenex Cottonelle Ultra Soft is even softer than the leading premium brand. Thick. It's thicker than the leading brand too, with more cottony soft tissue in every sheet. And finally, Kleenex, a word you've been comfortable with all your life. Kleenex Cottonelle Ultra Soft has three words of comfort for your family. Soft, thick, Kleenex. Kleenex Cottonelle Ultra Soft.
Another empty box of potato air crisps.
One of these, and then I'll mingle. Mmm, tastes like a potato chip, only crispier. Wait a minute, I should be talking to other people, not myself. But these are so crispy. It's the little air pockets. I'll just have one more. I don't need to circulate. If anybody wants to talk to me, they'll find me. I'm the blonde in the short black dress, holding an empty box of potato air crisps.
Potato air crisps with a crispier crunch than potato chips. You'll be back.
With the greatest of ease, the first of its kind, a fabulously flexible unwire. Introducing the Cross Your Heart Bra with Dream Shapers. For the surprisingly flexible, looks so natural, cross your heart shape of your dreams. No wonder everyone's asking, is that a Playtex under there?
Tonight, a mother's sacrifice will come back to haunt her.
Didn't a day go by? I didn't think about you.
The unforgettable conclusion of Alex Haley's Mama Flora's Family, CBS Tonight.
Now, James, don't get yourself all worked up, because it's not going to do anybody any good.
I'm going to find him.
Well, if he's to be found, you surely will find him. But come on, you know Emily. She hasn't got an honest bone in her pretty body. I don't think that David ever called her. I really don't.
Oh, God. What? I've got visitors.
So?
You have to hide. You have to.
Every damn time somebody comes here.
It's okay, Matthew. I know the way.
What the hell is it going to take to get through to you?
Weren't we just talking, darling? Really, this is not a good time.
Yeah, well, then make time. Your daughter, she's been under so much stress the last few weeks, and what do? You just keep piling it on.
I'd certainly do not.
She needs peace. She needs quiet.
Of course she does.
You've got enough on your plate right now. You're worrying about Sam, you got her daughter that you're dealing with, and you got James breathing down her neck. Leave Lily alone. How's that?
I don't like you haranguing me like this in the middle of the night. And just for your information, my daughter will always be at the top of my list of priorities.
Okay, fine. You want to help her out? Then stay the hell out of her way. And don't ever mention what might have happened to David Stenbeck again. Are you clear on that?
I'm so sorry. I wouldn't do anything to embarrass you. So here's to the best friend I ever had. The best to her future. She's been a little short in the happiness department, so let's wish her a lot of that, too. She's not only one of a kind. She's the best. To Camille.
Here, here.
Thank you, Brad.
Come on, that's enough.
Well, we made it through that one. My goodness. See, now, see, this is what happens when you have an open bar. Everybody wants to make a speech. Seriously, though, I want to thank you all for coming tonight. And I want a special thanks to my fabulous fiancé, who's the one who threw this bash.
I'll second that.
And third it.
Really, you all have been so kind and so supportive. I am a lucky lady, the luckiest, especially since I have all of you here with me tonight. Thank you.
Thank you.
Congratulations, you guys.
Satisfied now? You're so
you can go to hell anytime.
You couldn't steal her away from Ben, although I bet you tried like hell. And even when she turned you down, you couldn't have enough self-control to stop yourself from ruining their party. Is this what they've got to look forward to the rest of their life?
I want another drink.
Yeah, want it all you want. You're not gonna get it.
What, I gotta stand here, listen to you, tell me what a pathetic excuse I am for a human being without booze?
Basically,
no way. Molly, get me another drink.
Molly, stay put.
A New Year's Eve ceremony makes it doubly romantic. Just think, every year when New Year's Eve rolls around, you'll have the best memory of your life to relive.
You can't beat that.
Someone special is waiting for you at Sears Portrait Studio. It's Rudolph from the new movie Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, and you'll find him at Sears. Come in now and get your holiday portraits for only $6.95 a sheet. Have them taken with the most famous reindeer of all on Sears' new Rudolph background. And take home this new collectible Rudolph portrait ornament free. Get holiday portraits of your special someone with our special someone for only $6.95. Only for a limited time at Sears. Hurry in.
What's the taste of good times together? It's easy to recall.
Butterball turkeys are deep basted, so they're always juicy, always tender.
The best of all is Butterball.
You can visibly reduce the signs of aging on your hands with Neutrogena New Hands. The pro-retinol formula diminishes fine lines, reduces the look of age spots, restores a more youthful tone. Reveal younger looking hands with Neutrogena New Hands.
All living things depend on it. We need it to be clear, crisp, fresh. So we depend on Brita. Chlorine and 99% of lead are removed. Mercury is no longer a problem. Brita. It's how we know our tap water is wonderful water.
Or peeling.
Might be right.
Or Pedialyte!
If you haven't tasted Pedialyte recently, you may be in for a surprise. The number one choice of pediatricians for helping prevent dehydration from diarrhea tastes great.
More Pedialyte, please.
Pedialyte. In three delicious flavors. Also, try Pedialyte Freezer Pops.
Friday, kids think Bill Cosby's hard of hearing.
The cold! The
cold! Oh, you don't have a cold.
All new Kids Yell the Darndest Things. Then on Candid Camera, would you go up in an airplane with one engine missing?
No, we're not, actually.
I'm worried about you being the pilot.
All new Candid Camera, CBS Friday.
Sunday, the long-awaited sequel to The Miracle Worker.
Do you want Helen?
I am not a child.
Roma Downey and Moira Kelly, Monday after The Miracle, CBS Sunday.
The new way doctors can spot women's heart trouble years before there's a problem, tonight.
You okay?
Sure.
Brad didn't upset you?
He's just a little emotional, and drinking like that didn't help.
No, it didn't. Coming here tonight didn't help either, especially since the one he's a little emotional about is you.
You know, Ben, I never mentioned this before, but I'm the second friend of Brad's who's had breast cancer. Yeah, and you know, he's been watching me go through everything, the complications, and especially this last thing when they took me off of chemo. So I think that this has probably been drudging up a lot of emotions and feelings that he thought that he had left behind.
That might explain the drinking, but...
Sure. Look, you know how people get when you've been drinking too much. They get all sentimental and mushy. So, look, just don't be too hard on him. Brad's a good friend who just let his emotions get the best of him.
Camille, we're not talking about a good friend who got a little sentimental.
Ben, really, I just...
We all could see it, Camille. When Brad got up there to make his toast, he wanted to say a hell of a lot more than here's to my good friend, Camille. That man has something on his chest that he wants to get off real bad. And it's about you.
Here.
Molly, I don't want any coffee.
Just put it down. Fine, you know what? You don't want any coffee? That's fine. Let's go take a walk outside.
What do you think I am? Totally sloshed or something? I had a couple of drinks.
Man, I know how you are when you drink, all right? And the last thing this party needs is another public spectacle. So we are going to go talk outside.
Keep making these assumptions, Jack. Like, one, I'm drunk. Or two, I want to listen to another one of your lectures here.
Listen, man, I said no more booze.
Oh, hey. Nice move,
you know,
Jack.
I would have thought you'd remember how out of control you get when you drink.
No, you don't.
You know, whatever the hell was going on between you and Camille, whether it was you playing mind games while she was sick or trying to get her in the sack or
whatever it was, just stay out of my life. Get your own, okay?
Hey, you're the one who was sporting your dirty laundry in public tonight, not me. But you just couldn't help yourself, could you? You see something that you can't have, and you'll do your damnedest to ruin what they've got.
I didn't try to come here to ruin anything.
You lose control again?
Oh, Jack. When I do, you'll feel it.
You trash. My brother, trash. I mean, look at you, man. You're drunk. Hitting on someone else's woman, as usual. And you're probably not done yet, are you? You're probably gonna go out and kick back a few more, and you're not gonna quit until you kill what they've got. Just like it killed our father. Come on.
Hey, no, no.
Let's go.
No fighting, Brad. No, no more fighting, all right? I don't want to get hurt. Just don't start anything, Brad, all right? Now, look. I want to go home. But I need you to drive me. Please say you will, because I really need you right now. Please.
He wants you, Camille.
So I was never supposed to know, huh? Ain't you a piece of work?
Yeah, of course. No wonder.
What?
You thought this baby is yours.
It is, Carly.
And I was wondering why all of a sudden you became my own private security guard, the obstetrician from hell. Because you wanted your own flesh and blood. You wanted this baby to be born and be born healthy. Ego.
You know, if you originally you came to me professing this great deep love for Hal, but you needed a little help in getting pregnant, did you? So you could have this wonderful family life with Hal. Not only that, but you could control a $50 million trust.
And you could keep Barbara away from Hal.
If you had had the child, if you had kept your marriage together,
everything would have been just fine.
Right. You were going to let Hal and me raise your child.
I would have given it a try. I knew you were a greedy person, but I figured, well, probably has normal maternal instincts. I thought she will always put the child first, but I had a hell of a lot to learn about you, didn't I? I mean, there was a $50 million. There was this deadline, $50 million.
Hey, what? I always put this baby first, and I will be a damn good mother.
Oh, as you have been up to this point. If you could ever get past this obsession you have with Jack Snyder. You follow the damn guy all over the countryside. You never ever think of the health of this child that you're carrying.
I didn't do anything on purpose to hurt this baby.
You would go anywhere. You would do anything to get Snyder or the money, depending upon where your mind was on that day.
Just cut me some slack. It's not my... Everything is not my fault, you
know? All you had to do was keep your marriage. Demonstrate that you were a good mother. I would have taken the damn secret to the grave with me.
Yeah, well, I guess that's not going to happen now.
No, it's not. How can it? We have a little truth here now, you and me, don't we? Well, it makes me think very differently about this pregnancy.
So you suggest what? Exactly. That you and I act like parents.
Lily needs to get her strength back. She doesn't need you asking questions that she can't answer, especially about dating.
Okay, all right, all right.
Hello.
It's Julia. I was... Holmes, something happened. There was nothing I could do. I just ran.
Whoa, Julia, slow down. What are you talking about?
Okay. I was walking back to my car, Holmes, and the trunk was open, so I went back to close it, and... Oh, God, Holmes, it's so awful.
Julia, just calm down, okay? I'm having a real hard time following you here, so just take it back to the beginning, okay?
The shovel. Holmes, the shovel was in the trunk. The one that we used to bury David, it was there, all covered with dirt from the grave. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry that I'm freaking out like this. I'm really, really sorry, but all I could think of was, oh, what if David's not in that grave anymore? What if, just what if he's not dead? What if he's using that shovel to signal us? He knows where we are. He knows what we're doing because, he is not dead, and he's going to come after us.
Just, you got to listen to me, okay? You've got to stop this. That can't be David. We both know that.
When I heard the news, there was a non-prescription medicine, Excedrin migraine, proven to relieve migraine headache pain. Did I believe it? No, not really. But after trying just about everything else, I figured, what the heck? So I tried Excedrin migraine. You know what? It relieves migraine pain. Do I expect you to believe it? No. Not until you try it.
Excedrin Migraine, the only non-prescription medicine approved for migraine pain relief.
November 13th.
Still coming home for Christmas?
Yes, sir.
Jonathan Taylor Thomas is in the suit.
Oh, boy, wet lap.
And on the road. Disney's I'll Be Home for Christmas, rated PG, starts this Friday.
Victoria's Secret introduces Dream Angels, an impossibly romantic new bra. Dream Angels. It's only at Victoria's Secret. Sweet dreams.
I'm really hungry.
Starving.
The Surprise Sounds Kitchen from Sesame Street is the busiest kitchen around. It talks.
Time for popcorn in the red pot.
Let's cook soup.
It makes fun sounds.
Hungry!
Surprise Sounds Kitchen from Sesame Street. And they even get to clean up.
Look what Daddy gets. Looks good, huh?
You eat those peas.
This is Daddy's.
When you make a Spamburger hamburger.
Oh, my.
Watch out.
Perfect.
Because the premium pork and ham, spiced to perfection, makes Spam so good, it's gone. Spam so good, it's gone.
Stay tuned for more of As the World Turns.
Sunday.
What's this?
Things I've got to do before I die.
A child's last wish.
Help mom finish the song.
Becomes a mother's greatest test.
If I finish it, he'll die.
He's in so much pain.
Wynonna and Celine Dion on the extraordinary 100th episode of Touched by an Angel, CBS Sunday.
Is your dry cleaner ripping you off? Special assignment tonight.
Hi, I'm Jonathan Winters for California Fresh Eggs.
We all love eggs in our family.
I've had as many as 8 or 10 hard-boiled eggs. Cook up maybe 50. A lot of eggs.
My mom loves eggs. My dad loves eggs.
Cheese omelets.
Eggs Benedict.
Sunny side up.
My grandpa loves eggs. My grandma.
Bring me my hard-boiled eggs.
And my sisters and brothers.
Schlungy, that's good.
Have an egg.
And even my doggy and kitty love eggs.
And it's fun to do this.
California Fresh Eggs. They're good. Really good.
Mom says there's no money for college.
Then do what I did. I took the medical assisting course at Bryman.
Yeah, but how long did it take?
Just a few months. They even placed me in an externship program. That's how I met Dr. Radley.
Look, why don't you give them a call and have them send you an information package? I think Mom's gonna like this.
Call 800-722-7337. 722-7337. Call now.
Frankfurt, Germany was named after Hermann Frankfurt, a famous wiener maker.
Don't say it!
Catch Billy Baldwin, Kristen Johnston, and Cindy Crawford on the next Hollywood Squares.
Tonight at 7:30 on CBS 2.
The address is CBS. Welcome home.
Julia, you said yourself that you were scared, so it follows that you might not be thinking straight here.
I know that.
And when it comes to David, we both know that...
Julia, just a moment, dear. Look, Holden, she's clearly very upset. Why don't you go and talk to her personally, and you and I will speak another day.
Julia, hang on. I came here to make sure that you understand.
I do understand. I'm with you. You're the boss. You call the shots all the way. But this girl is very upset, because after all, she hasn't gotten over the trauma that she had in the woods.
Julia, where are you? I'll come meet you.
I'm not that far away from where my car is parked. I'm sorry, Holden. I'm really, really sorry to bother you like this, but I had the thought of going back to that car and seeing that shovel again all by myself.
All right, just stay there. I'll be right there, all right? Remember what I said.
And you drive carefully, dear.
Very interesting. Very interesting.
Really? Yeah. Him carrying on about me and Lily, it seems to me that's par for the course.
No. What Holden said on the phone, I think Holden and Julia Lindsay know something about David.
Oh, the poor girl's having an attack of the vapors. I don't think she's very strong mentally.
And you? You called Lily and talked about David. Are you onto something? Tell me.
I think all of us have been upset by David's reign of terror. Now, I called Lily, and unfortunately, I upset her more.
Lucinda, you don't waste time gossiping. You're a very, very intelligent woman. Do you have a theory?
A theory?
Yes, are you on to something? Are you on to something?
No, I don't know anything.
Lucinda. Now, you and I are engaged to be married. If you know something, tell me. If you think something I need to know, tell me.
But I don't know anything.
Fine. I'm on my own. I'm gonna keep digging until I find my son.
James, please wait. What kind of creep would do this, huh? Go running off into the next room, make your donation, and then lie about it like you're some kind of god.
I've never felt like a god.
That's bull. You played with my life. You played with my child's life. And you enjoyed it.
I do not enjoy this anymore.
Stop lying. You and I both know that you did this for yourself, so you could hold on to dear, sweet Barbara. You're sick. And it's just my rotten luck that because you're screwed up, I might be carrying your child. You know, this could be worse than I ever imagined it could
be. Listen to me. Maybe you'd rather wind up pregnant and half dead in the trunk of some damn car.
David Stenbeck is off your back. The only reason you found out about this at all was because I was covering up for you one more time. Now I have defused James. We'll have a paternity test and he'll be gone. So don't you make me the villain of this piece. I'm giving you a shot at the only two things you ever worried about in your entire life. That's this baby and $50 million.
Maybe.
Maybe what?
There's no proof yet that you're the father of this child. God. Yeah, Hal and I did make love that night. God, after everything I've been through, now I have to deal with you too. I don't know if I can do it. I don't know if I can go through the rest of this pregnancy without knowing who the father is.
Listen to me. You can get through this pregnancy very well.
How's that?
By taking care of your baby and by finally listening to me.
Come on, Brad. Come on. It'll only take a minute. We'll get it to go. Look, you really could use a cup of coffee.
Hey, I'm not drunk.
Then why are you so loud? What'll it be, folks? Two medium hazelnuts.
One. Thank you. I don't want coffee.
What about something to eat? A sandwich, a few donuts. Brad, food would really help sober you up.
Just get that one coffee, okay?
Talk to me, Brad. Look, you want to talk about the engagement party? Open up about it? I mean, sometimes when you talk about things, it really helps make it better. No? Okay, your call. So what about Jack? What's up with you and Jack? And does he really hate you that much, or does he just like pushing you around? Because, I mean, I know he's Ben's good friend and everything, but I have never heard him say a nice word to you. I mean, how can you talk to your own brother
it's
like that?
Long story, all right? Long story.
Well, I got all night. What did you do? Steal a Swiss Army knife when you were kids, but... Oh, I know, don't tell me. You were in love with the same girl, you won, and he never got over. That is so romantic. It is, I could put that in my next romance novel like that.
What?
I was asking you why you and Jack don't get along.
Oh, it's a long story, right?
Yeah, right, I know, I got that part. Whew, man, this is getting tiring.
What?
Doing all the talking. Have you figured it out yet?
What?
How to get over. I mean, you either gotta find a way to live with it, or you gotta get over it. But the way I see it is every time you get a glimpse of Camille or you have a couple drinks, that live with it part is gonna go right out the window. So I suggest that you find a way to get over.
Right.
Easier said than done. I know. I had an awful time getting over Holden, you know. It worked, though. I got over him. Time, I guess.
I don't know if I had that kind of time.
Well, then I guess you better find a way to start tonight.
Medium hazelnut, 150.
You keep that change.
Thanks. Thank you. Brad, wait, what's up? Where are we going?
We're gonna go do what you just said.
You say that you closed the trunk.
Yeah, because I couldn't look at it anymore, and, well, what if someone else saw it, right?
Okay, I need the keys.
Well, you're gonna open it?
Well, I need to see if the shovel is in there. I need to see if the dirt is there with it. How else am I gonna handle this, Julia?
You don't believe me. You think I'm crazy.
I think you're scared.
No. No, it was there. Hold on, not 30 minutes ago. I saw it. It was here. It was right here.
There are 7 million kids in this country who wet the bed. Often because their bladders haven't grown as quickly as the rest of their bodies. One product can help, that protects, yet looks and feels like real underwear. It's helping a lot of kids feel better about themselves. Good nights mean good mornings.
Sure,
is a sensitive problem. But bladder leakage happens to a lot of us. Worse yet, it happens unexpectedly, and so does the odor. Well, fortunately, there's an answer. It's called Stay Fresh from FDS. It's the first and only spray that actually neutralizes urine odor. Stay Fresh works as you need it. You just spray it on in the morning, and even an unexpected accident isn't an odor problem anymore.
New FDS Stay Fresh, the answer to odor from bladder leakage.
I'm nothing without you, my sweet love. I'm just a simple tree, but with you I'm complete. I'm nothing without you,
Cool Whip,
my sweet love.
The Braun Thermoscan is the only thermometer that gives an accurate reading in just 1 second. Without disturbing your child. The Braun Thermoscan, the first choice of pediatricians.
Water. It's in every strand of hair. But blow-drying can dry it out. The new SensorCare from Philips has a unique heat sensor that measures your hair's temperature and automatically adjusts, so your hair never overheats. It's healthy, shiny, full of life. The new SensorCare from Philips.
Is this it?
Yeah.
Well, I got you here. I mean, not that it was easy, though. I mean, you barely spoke to me in the car. You know, when you tell someone, turn here, you usually give them a little more fair warning. You know, Brad, this is a really weird place to come. And it's absolutely freezing. Why are we here? Do I ever get to know?
Camille asked me to build a dream house here. Build it with my bare hands.
Brad. Look. If I thought that there was something I could do... Look, I know that you're in a really dark place right now. But I'm also really glad that you didn't pour out your heart at their engagement party. Not that it matters, because everybody could tell anyway. It
doesn't matter. The only thing that matters is the booze is wearing off right now.
Are you starting to see things a little differently?
No, Molly, no. I love her more than ever.
Great. Sorry.
No, look. This is good, all right? What we're doing is good, okay?
Okay. What are we doing?
Look, if I can't build her house, if I can't have her, I'm gonna do the official groundbreaking, all right?
That's why we're here?
Camille, this is for you.
One's enough, right? Come on, Brad. Please, let's go to someplace warm. Let's get you some hot coffee, please. I don't know why anybody would want to dream about living way out here anyway. I mean, this place is downright spooky.
Susan, thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome. It was a wonderful party.
Bob, really appreciate you showing up.
My pleasure. I'll see you tomorrow. Kim, I'll have him bring up the car.
Okay, honey, thanks. Well, I have to hand it to you, Camille.
What?
Well, what you went through here tonight with Brad was no fun, to put it mildly.
He just had a little bit too much to drink. I'm sorry if he offended anybody or made anybody feel uneasy.
No. Oh, no, please don't misunderstand me. I'm not talking about us. I mean you. I think you conducted yourself with such grace in a difficult situation. Most of us take years to learn how to do that. Perfect party. Thank you so much.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you for a wonderful party.
Ah, thank you.
We're all set.
Good night.
Drive safe.
Thank you.
Good night.
Night, all right.
Didn't I tell you you need to do something about him? Mama, he just had a little bit too much to drink and he let his emotions... Oh, don't try to blame it on booze. He should be out of your life. He should stay out of your life, and I told you that earlier. Can you keep your voice down, please? Me? Keep my voice down? Fine. But you know what? I'm gonna go set him straight. I'm gonna get him out of your life. Shh. You know what? I can't get over you. You can't stay out of my business for more than 2 seconds. I swear to God, Mama, if you go anywhere near him... Then why don't you do what you should do and you tell him to get out of your life? Tell him don't come within 50 feet of you, and if he does, you're gonna get a court order.
So, do I get 3 guesses why Sarah Ruth was so upset?
you need three?
Nope. Liz, I'd really like to apologize for my brother. I mean, sometimes it gets a little out of control.
Jack, you're not your brother's keeper. What happened tonight wasn't your fault.
Look, he just had a little bit too much.
Well, frankly, I feel responsible for him even being in Oakdale. I mean, if I didn't live here, he would have left a long time ago. Sometimes I think his only goal in life is to make my living hell.
No, that's not why Brad settled in Oakdale. I think we all know the real reason.
You know, I'm awfully tired. Shouldn't we be going?
Yeah, you know it's going to be that time, isn't it? Yeah, that's weird. Where'd Julia go?
Well, it was there. I saw it. I touched it. I got dirt on my fingers.
Well, it's not here now. There's no shovel, no dirt.
No, it was there.
Julia, I don't know what to say. Your truck is perfectly clean. It's spotless.
I know what you're thinking. She's crazy. She's hallucinating.
No, it's a possibility. You haven't been sleeping. It's dark in here. You're scared.
Okay, fine. What if I am hallucinating? What do I do?
You get help.
No! No, I have thought of that. Jack mentioned it. The idea of going to a therapist is totally, totally impossible.
Why?
Because if I go to a psychiatrist and talk to him about seeing things that are not there, eventually I'm gonna have to tell him what those things are, like a shovel we use to bury a body.
Julia, this situation is just getting worse for you. You need to get help. That's all that matters here.
No, no, Dalton, don't you understand? If I go to a psychiatrist, I'm gonna have to start talking about David, how he died, where he's buried.
To hell with that. The only thing that matters is you getting better.
No, this is not just about me.
Look, a psychiatrist is sworn to secrecy. Doctor, client, confidentiality. If you tell them, you tell them.
No, no.
Julia, keeping this a secret is starting to eat away at you. You can't go on like this much longer. And it's all my fault.
No, it's not. It's David's.
Well, David is not here to accept responsibility for this. So I think it's time that I did.
What?
I think it's time that I go to the police and tell them. Confess everything.
I'm a real wild one.
Wild one. I'm a real wild one.
Kids are born to be wild. It's just whether they'll do it on your furniture or our toys. Help channel their creative energy with the Little Tykes Creative Art Studio. With a built-in light table, swivel chair, and room for all their art supplies. Little Tykes. Fun that lasts.
Why do you always do better at Burlington Coat Factory?
I always find a great selection of designer clothes.
All the most contemporary styles.
I can get two suits for the price of one suit elsewhere.
Designer shoe department is fabulous.
You can't find a better place for kids' clothing than Burlington Coat Factory.
They have everything that you could possibly want for a baby.
Great linen department.
Burlington Coat Factory has prices lower than department stores, even on sale.
Burlington Coat Factory, we're more than great coats.
Mom loves when I make frosted cupcakes for us. Hurry up, the icing's ready.
No ugly dish will make me miss Kate's big dessert.
And thanks to Dawn, I won't.
Dawn antibacterial surrounds and dissolves the toughest grease, better than any brand. Plus, it kills germs on hands, so you'll have no worries here.
Hi, Mommy. His voice freaks
us. With Dawn, I don't miss a thing.
Dawn antibacterial takes grease out of your way.
The party's in there, so why am I out here? Gas. Again.
Maximum Strength Phazyme has 33% more medicine doctors recommend.
One little pill, and I'm back.
Serious medicine for serious gas. Phazyme.
Now that the money has the new advanced battery, it's a whole new ballgame. You have to be prepared for just about anything. Ain't that right, boys?
New Energizer Advanced Formula. No battery lasts longer.
I am awfully tired. Can we get going?
Can I meet you in the lobby?
Yeah. Have I said thank you for such a wonderful night?
Yeah, well, it didn't turn out quite the way I planned it.
Hey, I loved it. And I know everyone had a good time. Like, nothing went wrong. Not for me, anyway. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
Hey.
She disappeared on me again.
Your brother is one troubled guy.
Yeah, he sure as hell shouldn't drink.
No, it wasn't the liquor talking. It was like you said, his friendship with Camille.
Hey, Camille may call it a friendship.
I hear you. It was so obvious. He wants a hell of a lot more from Camille than just a friendship.
First things first. First, I gotta find Julia, and then I'll pay Brad a visit.
Wait. Why?
To finish what we started here. Listen, I'm sorry about the fight, but I'll find some place to deal with him later on tonight.
No, Jack, you have your own beef with Brad. That's fine, but I'm asking you to stay out of this business with Camille. It's my problem. I'm gonna take care of it.
Yeah, you're just full of wisdom and lectures about motherhood and its virtues, aren't you? And you're pretty cocky, too. Just assuming that you are the father of this baby and that Hal isn't.
Artificial insemination is far more scientific than the old-fashioned way.
Okay, so say that you are the father. What are you gonna do about it?
What do you mean?
Are you gonna go public with it?
Go public?
Yeah, Mr. Cock, sure. If you are Daddy Dearest, are you gonna fess up? Are you gonna admit it? And get James Stenbeck off my back?
Why are you so nervous?
I'm not nervous.
Why do you keep insisting I shouldn't leave?
I'm just afraid that you'll sail away, and I don't know when my ship will come back again.
I don't know. There's something going on. I think you're keeping something from me.
No, I told you.
Well, Emily says she's been contacted by David. Julia calls Holden. So frightened she doesn't know what to do. She calls Holden. Why not Jack? Why not her lover, the cop? And then Holden comes over here, berserk, because you talked to Lily about David?
You know how he is. Overprotective, my son-in-law.
What does Lily know?
Nothing. This is absurd.
Something strange going on here. I think my son's out there, and I think people know about it. And I think that's why you called Lily. And I think that's what upset her so much. I think that's what upset Lily so much.
Don't you go near Lily. You leave Lily alone, because there's absolutely nothing going on. You hear me when I say that? There's absolutely nothing going on.
I'm gonna find my son.
Don't you go near Lily!
Why not?
Because if you do, you just ruin my surprise.
What surprise?
I've arranged for us to be married tonight.
Holden, you cannot go to the police.
I can't keep putting you through this just because I'm afraid of admitting that I killed him.
No, absolutely not.
Julia, please, don't argue with
Holden,
me about this.
Holden, no, listen to me. I was there when Hope was born. I am responsible for her, too. Now, if you go to the police and confess, then everything that Lily and I went through this summer, everything we all went through this summer, for nothing. I'm a big girl, and I'm a lot tougher than I've been acting lately. I will be okay.
All right. Just so long as you go get help.
Fine. But you have to promise that you won't breathe a word about this to the police.
Okay. As long as you get help.
I will. I just have to figure out some way not to specifically mention David's death. Whew, Brad. Come on, Brad, this place is scary, and it's cold.
Go wait in the car.
I don't want to wait in the car. I just want you to stop being obsessive, okay? Look, Brad, I've been where you are, and it's no good. Trust me, it makes you do crazy things and starts messing up your life, okay? And you just really, you gotta let it go. Brad, are you listening to me?
Yeah.
You know, this place is cursed. It is, I can feel it. I just get this really, really bad vibe here. Would you look at yourself? Would you look at what you're doing, Brad? This groundbreaking ceremony is getting weirder by the minute, all right? Plus, you know, it can't be good for you. It is absolutely freezing out here, and you're getting all sweaty, digging this big hole, drinking after I don't know how much booze. Finally.
I hit something.
A rock?
No, this is something strange.
Hello, it's me. Your skin? I don't usually do endorsements, but for a new Vaseline intensive care lotion, I'll make an exception. Vaseline's the only lotion with new skin protection complex. When I'm dry, it heals me. But here's what really excites me. Now Vaseline also protects me from the sun, cold, wind, even water. I feel marvelous. Hey, I'm the only skin you've got. Take care of me. Take Vaseline intensive care of me.
I could not believe how much cat hair the whirlwind picked up.
The greatest feature? No bags.
It's like a cyclone going on inside my vacuum cleaner.
Cyclonic action. It's the concept of channeling air that makes a Eureka whirlwind so effective.
I have really bad allergies.
The whirlwind's true HEPA seal filtration captures all the particles right here, 100%.
No more sneezing. No more red eyes.
Let's talk about attachments. All you have to do is pull the hose out and you're in business.
Less than $200? You've got to be kidding.
You thought it was over with, but you're still smoking. You keep trying to quit, but you keep lighting up. Zyban can help you look at quitting a whole new way. It's the nicotine in cigarettes that's addictive. It's been proven. And most people need help to quit. Today, there's nicotine-free Zyban. Not a patch, not a gum. Instead, the first pill that is part of a comprehensive program from your doctor can help you quit smoking. Zyban is prescription medicine that can help reduce your urge to smoke and make quitting bearable. It's important to know there's a risk of seizure associated with Zyban. To reduce the risk, don't take Zyban if you've had an eating or seizure disorder or are being treated with Wellbutrin. Don't take Zyban if you're taking an MAO inhibitor. Quitting is tough, and Zyban won't work for everyone. Call now for a $5 coupon and free product information. Ask your doctor if Zyban is right for you. And break free from nicotine. Break free from smoking.
The Marines are accused of killing their own. Is it a fact or a reporter out of control?
You knew the truth.
He deliberately left things out.
All new JAG, CBS Tonight.
CBS Wednesday. If you haven't seen To Have and To Hold, you're missing the season's most honest look at marriage and family.
Who says a man can't do laundry?
To Have and To Hold, then. A doctor learns to fly.
Oh!
But her instructor's heart attack could cut her lesson short. All new Chicago Hope, CBS Wednesday.
Tonight on the CBS Evening News, the painless new procedure that helps doctors spot heart disease years before there's a problem. The story later.
More channels than ever.